The Sneetches and Our Stories by Dr. Seuss. The Sneetches.
Now, the star-bellied Sneetches had bellies with stars. The plain-bellied Sneetches had none upon theirs. Those stars weren't so big. They were really so small, you might think such a thing wouldn't matter at all. But because they had stars, all the star-bellied Sneetches would brag,
"We're the best kind of Sneetch on the beaches."
With their snoots in the air, they would sniff and they'd snort,
"We'll have nothing to do with the plain-bellied sort."
And whenever they met some, when they were out walking, they'd hike right on past them without even talking. When the star-bellied children went out to play ball, would the plain-bellied get to the game? Not at all. You only could play if your bellies had stars, and the plain-bellied children had none above bars. When the star-bellied snitches had pencil roses, or pickles, or carpets, or marshmallow toasts, they never invited the plain-bellied snitches.
Also known as Sylvester Molester McMonkey McSpanky.
And I've heard of your troubles. I've heard you're unhappy. But I can fix that. I'm the fix-it-up chappie. I've come here to help you. I have what you need. And my prices are low. And I work at great speed. And my work is 100% guaranteed.
Then quickly, Sylvester McMonkey McBean put together a very peculiar machine. And he said,
"You want stars like a star-bellied Sneetch? My friends, you can have them for $3 each. Just pay me your money and hop right aboard."
So they clambered inside. Then the big machine roared. And it clung, and it bumped, and it jerked, and it burped, and it bopped them about. But the thing really worked. When the plain-bellied Sneetches popped out, they had stars. They actually did. They had stars upon bars.
We've got stars now.
They yelled at the ones who had stars at the start.
"We're exactly like you. You can't tell us apart. We're all just the same now, you snooty old smarties. And now we can go to your Frankfurter parties."
Oh, good grief.
The ones who had stars at the first.
"We're still the best Sneetches, and they are the worst. But how now in the world will we know?"
They all frown.
"If which kind is what, or the other way round?"
Then up came McBean with a very sly wink, and he said,
"Things are not quite as bad as you think. So you don't know who's who. That's perfectly true. But come with me, friends. Do you know what I'll do? I'll make you again the best Sneetches on beaches. And all it will cost you is $10 eaches." "Belly stars are no longer in style," said McBean. "What you need is a trip through my star-off machine. This wondrous contraption will take off your stars, so you won't look like Sneetches who have them on bars."
A
and that handy machine,
working very precisely, removed all the stars from their tummies quite nicely. With their snoots in the air, they paraded above, and they opened their beaks, and they let out a shout.
We know
the who's.
Now, the best kind of sneetches are sneetches without
O-U-T out.
Then, of course, those with stars all got frightfully mad. To be wearing a star now was frightfully bad. Then, of course, old Sylvester McMonkey McBean invited them into his star-off machine. And, of course, from then on, as you probably guess, things really got into a horrible mess. All the rest of that day on those wild, screaming beaches, the fix-it-up chappie kept fixing up sneetches. Off again, on again, in again, out again, through the machines they raced round and about again, changing their stars every minute or two. They kept paying money, they kept running through, until neither the plane nor the star bellies knew whether this one was that one, or that one was this one, or which one was what one, or what one was who! Then, when every last cent of their money was spent, the fix-it-up chappie packed up, and he went. And he laughed as he drove in his car up the beach.
They never will learn. No, you can't teach a sneetch.
But McBean was quite wrong. I'm quite happy to say that the sneetches got really quite smart on that day. That day, they decided that sneetches are sneetches. And no kind of sneetch is the best on the beaches. That day, all the sneetches forgot about stars, and whether they had one or not, upon bars.